All right, this is the last episode of Tales of a Wedding Ring. Until the next ones get dubbed, you know how it is for us dubs. We're about two episodes behind the original, so let's jump right into it.
She ran away.
Apologies. The princess is a hopeless shut-in, I'm afraid. She's quite special. Sadly, she's always been terrified of outsiders. I think you'll find it challenging to fulfill your duty here.
I see. And who might you be?
My name is Jade Romka, her brother. I'm the eldest son of the previous king. I imagine my sister left before sharing her name. As I said, Nefridis is shy. So,
how shy?
You're the famous ring king, all the way from another world.
I've been in here for 3 days.
3 days?
Is he really gonna lock me in jail forever?
Ring king.
Lord.
Whoa, who are you?
Don't be so loud, you'll draw their attention.
A dark elf? New waifu.
I'm gonna find out what you hope to accomplish by gathering the rings. Are you after world peace? Or maybe you want absolute power. But perhaps 5 beautiful wives is enough for you.
5 beautiful wives.
I don't know what your deal is. But the only thing I want is Hime's happiness. I'm in this for the marriage I've always wanted.
I'll admit I didn't expect that. You chose to take on enormous power, all for the sake of the woman you love. I like you.
Oh!
Let's head out, Ring King.
Are there more dark elves?
Before I follow you, I need to know what you're planning.
Simply to save my nation from the whims of a short-sighted prince. And in order to do that, I must ensure the Ring King can defeat the Abyss King. I think it should be quite obvious that you can't do that from a prison cell.
Facts.
The king sees the Tempest Wall as the ultimate protection, but in truth, it's a prison of our own making.
Thank you. It's just a prison. That's all it is.
Yes, that is one of the 5 rings of power, the Wind Regalia. The princess should have gotten it long ago.
I don't understand what it's doing here. Shouldn't the princess be carrying the ring?
Hide!
Is that some kind of new monster?
Nope. It's the princess.
She's praying to a statue of her mom and dad.
A statue? You've got it wrong. Their hearts have stopped and their bodies became petrified. But even in their present state, they continue to draw on the power of the ring to maintain the Tempest Wall. They're the real thing. The Elf King and his queen.
Oh my god!
Is someone in here with me?
You're bad at this.
Facts!
What? Stop that! It was all I could come up with. In a cave? What kind of bird would live in a cave?
So you're playing hide and seek? Well, that's not gonna work. I'm smarter than I look.
Not really.
Come out, you scoundrel!
You got me.
It's Sato, the Ring King.
Oh my gosh, he's here. The Ring King is here!
And she's down for the count.
Just
that'd be fast.
The shock from your appearance is too much for her.
Time to run.
This is probably the worst place we could be caught. Take Nefridis and leave. Quickly.
Wait, where should I take her?
Oh, I know a place. I can buy some time for you to get acquainted.
Don't trust her.
I'm an elder if I couldn't handle that.
What do you mean, elder? Princess? Nefridis has disappeared?
Yes, when we last saw her, she was entering the Wind Temple, but she's not been seen since.
Find her! Locating the princess is your only priority! It couldn't be.
Really? You're gonna put him alone in a room?
I've known the princess since the moment she was born. She seems like a timid girl, but she's strong at heart. She might respond well to a bit of persuasion. Do what you have to. That's the Ring King's job. Have fun, you two.
I would more want to be acquainted with you, if that was me.
Wait, wait, no. I'm just here to get the ring, nothing more. I've got to get my head on straight.
She's waking.
Someone help me, Sierra!
It's okay. I'm not gonna hurt you. Please calm down.
She about to throw up? Yeah.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to get any on you. You were just so close.
Don't worry about it. That shirt needed washing anyway.
It's gonna be hard to explain why y'all naked. I can't blame him for speaking.
Am I really that scary?
You're absolutely terrifying.
Pretty quick answer.
I've spent my whole life in the palace, so everyone from the outside is scary. I don't know how to talk to them. It's hard. You're from an entirely different world than mine. How am I supposed to be comfortable around a dimension-hopping superhero?
Dimension-hopping superhero. He's a high schooler. It's better. We have TV. Internet. Manga.
You're hesitating. It's a scary place, aren't you?
Video games.
A world that has oceans full of orcs and goblins. A place where you can be attacked by dragons just by walking down the street.
No.
It's nothing like that. There are no monsters in my world.
None whatsoever.
Think of it that way, it's pretty peaceful.
A peaceful world? A world with no monsters? Do you have any elves where you're from?
No. How about you grow up?
I like to read. The elder brings me the most wonderful books about the outside world, and I lose myself in them. I imagine the sights and smells, how it feels.
Introduce her to manga. One Piece. She'll be on your side.
I love it. It's so fun to picture it. When I'm reading, I feel like I could go anywhere. But the real me is stuck in her room and can't do anything on her own at all. It's pretty weird, isn't it?
Do anything on your own. I'm exactly the same way. I didn't come here because I thought I had some darkness-ending superpower. I just couldn't stand the thought of being left in a world without the woman I loved. So I ran. I took a chance and followed her. Honestly, I wouldn't change a thing.
So you took a chance.
He took a chance.
And I'll take one too.
Ooh, Lord.
Okay,
sure.
Totally. Yeah, that would be a great time. But you're a blanket.
Oh, Lord.
I'm sorry.
You scoundrel. Get away from her.
Sato. Wait, brother. Please let me explain. The Ring King is not the kind of man the rumors paint him to be.
Such foolishness. In one afternoon, he's deceived you. The ring belongs with our mother and father. It powers the tempest wall that preserves our safety. You know this, and yet you'd steal it.
It wouldn't be stealing. I was supposed to inherit it from her one day.
Facts.
I know that.
You're supposed to been give it to her.
Afraid is. To be very clear, I was not asking for your opinion.
He's forcing her.
Freeze, wait.
And now on to the Ring King. You've got a lot to answer for. Escaping from prison and kidnapping our princess. I assume you're prepared for the consequences.
You locked me up for no reason.
I'm afraid he was merely an accomplice.
It was you. I have no idea what you wanted from this stunt, but my patience has limits, Elder. What you've done today could be considered treason.
And what about what you've done? Do you really think you can get away with locking up the hero of a legend? I'll be taking the Ring King into my custody. Any objections?
That's fine with me. But you are never to show your face in front of my sister again. Understood?
But let's talk about the Elder.
Forgive the late introduction, Maiden of the Ring of Light. I'm Peridot, the oldest living elf in Ronka. Honored to meet you.
Bro, you gotta give the oldest living elf.
Princess Crystal. Navati no Kanatika.
Peridot, I hope it's okay to ask. The parents, do they have anything to do with the way Nefridis is?
Ring King, Maiden of the Ring of Light. There's a story I'd like to pass on to you. Of how Ronka came to be enveloped in the Tempest Wall. And it will explain why Nefridis behaves the way she does. To start off, Nefridis and Jade's mother was not the firstborn daughter meant to inherit the rings. She had an older sister. To ensure that the ring remained nearby to be passed down the royal line, it became the custom for the firstborn princesses to marry someone from their village. However, the eldest princess fell in love with a traveler, and a human traveler at that.
Oh.
The elves began to talk. If the traveler receives one of the rings, what's to stop him from taking it out of the village? No. Perhaps the traveler approached the princess with the intent to steal the ring from the very beginning. Rumors began to make their way from ear to ear. As more people talked, rumors grew into suspicion, and then later, conviction. The stronger the opposition from the village, the stronger her feelings for the traveler became. But one day, the traveler suddenly stopped visiting the village and the princess that loved him. She knew he had been driven off by the villagers trying to protect the rings.
Eventually.
Or killed by them.
That's awful.
Just for a ring? Why would they go that far?
The rings of power are a symbol of authority that have been handed down since the age of myth. In the past, they have even been used to legitimize entire governments.
Many nations yearn for their power. It can be intoxicating.
The villagers were relieved that the traveler was out of the picture. Just think, what must the princess have felt seeing her loss celebrated? What sort of decisions might she make? The elder princess's heart sank into rage and despair, and she left this village.
Yes.
Not before cursing it. May Ronka be swallowed by the abyss. May the line of ring maidens come to an end, she said. They took her words to heart. The curse weighed heavy on their minds. Because elves have such long lifespans, the fear that the curse could manifest at any moment continued. The more years passed, the more our people grew consumed by that fear. And the same held true for the royalty that remained. Nefridi's mother inherited the rings in the eldest princess's stead, but they still lived in fear of her curse. To keep the evil her sister had spoken from harming her people, she called upon the ring and erected a barrier of wind to protect this nation, to protect her children. And she paid a tremendous price. Before her final act, she asked Nefridis to make her a promise that she would remain within the bounds of the barrier forever. And she has, another casualty of the princess's curse. Nefridis wants to honor what her parents sacrificed their lives for. She's convinced she must.
And the brother basically forcing her to keep it.
I'm afraid that after this, your mother won't be able to talk to you any longer. Elves don't die of old age, but like anything else, when our hearts stop, so do we.
But mother, why is your heart going to stop?
Listen to me. You must swear never to venture outside the borders of this nation. Promise me.
She basically stopped her daughter's life. And we won't get another episode for the next 2 days. I'll see y'all in the next one. I'm out. Mm.